Welcome to my channel, Fat Daniel Dice. My name is Mildred Lee. Today I'm going to talk about part 2, Gouda, Day Out. This part is not going to be long. So, this is the stroopwafel. And what I did? I went to Intertoys. Oh, I went home. Arriving at station Rotterdam. This is gonna be real short. And I saw that the store, Starbucks. And I thought by myself, I try to find every year a specific thing that I see on YouTube that one of the influencers talk about. This year I didn't see anything or I didn't notice, but I still wanted to go to the store and see what they have. So I saw that. And I thought to myself, what's that? So I see a couple of mugs from, there was on this side, was Amsterdam, center was the Utrecht and The Hague. And I thought to myself, where's Rotterdam? I don't see Rotterdam. So apparently there was on the side next to Amsterdam, there was a little bit empty spot, but you had to bend down on your knees, bend your knees down. And then I saw like three boxes, because I grabbed the one in the near me and I pulled it out. And I saw, like I said, this box, and there was two of these boxes like stacked on each top of each other, because in front of that was an one box that was already open. So let's start with small box first, okay? So the small box I opened, because I already saw it out of the box, but I want to see, is it the same? Is it the same? I'm not buying an empty box. Of course I'm not buying empty box, because it came like this. It was in the box like this, and I'm talking, okay, I want to check if nothing's wrong with the mug, because I don't want to buy a broken one. So apparently, I think this is an espresso cup. It's quite small, and it's dark blue inside. Then you get windmill, and there's this ice skates, boating, I think the Afsluitdijk, I believe. I forget the name every time of this. The lighthouse, clumps, tulips, windmill, cows, bicycles, and cheese. I thought, that's nice. So I wanted to have a small one. Not that I'm drinking espresso, but I wanted a small one just to put something in. Maybe brick separators. I don't know. And I found, and what is the price? The price is €9.95. Actually, the price was here, but I told her, you don't have to remove the pricing. She said, no, I need to remove the price because there's a code in here. So apparently she needs to scan the code, otherwise it won't say that I paid for it. So then the big box, and you open the box, oops, you have to open it like this. Then it's like, it's not empty, but I want to show you how the box opens, the activity opening box. So the price is like almost €13. And I'm going to show you how it looks like. So this is the one. So I'm not now for now interested in the Amsterdam one, Utrecht and The Hague, because I want my own one, the Rotterdam. So you got the Erasmusbrug, it's a bridge, Erasmus Bridge. They call it the Swan, the backdrop of all the high flats, apartments, and so on, and companies. You got the soccer ball. I think the special sport place, for our new Feyenoord place. I think it's not done yet, so they haven't placed it. The special boat, spitting water, the windmill, the backdrop, that one is a town hall. This one, I don't know what kind of building that is. I don't know this one. Then you got, I believe this is Rijkswaterstaat. This is the building that I've worked in, but it's not yellow and brown. The Rijkswaterstaat is like dark purple, blackish building. Then you have the, I believe it's the Meijerhuis. But everyone calls it the white building, because they can never memorize the name. So everybody called it the White House. Not the White House like in the American one. Just because they don't know what its name, and it's the color is white. That's why we call it the White House. I believe this is a Rijnaak. This is a tall boat. I don't know what that is. We love boats. So there are a lot of boats in here. Oh, this is the this is the station. This is our station in Rotterdam. The central station. We think it's ugly. But, okay. It was well needed to have a new building of our central station. So, that's why they built this one. But, okay. But the inside is dark gray. I believe the Amsterdam is beautiful blue. This kind of blue. And I don't remember the color of Utrecht anymore and The Hague. No, wait, I remember again. Utrecht and The Hague color is like that color. I don't know if it's in here. It's the burgundy red. So, I mean dark red color. Not red, but dark brownish red color. Dark red brownish color. That's The Hague and the Utrecht one. So, I don't know. The Amsterdam, all the buildings and the sites, the landmarks, are light blue, dark blue colored. All of them. So that's, I think it's boring. Look, at least here you have yellow color. You know, next to gray, dark blue, and the brown. I did not memorize the Utrecht and the Hague colors of the mug, but it's hard for me to memorize a lot of things. When I was young, 18, 21, I could memorize a lot of things, but when I gradually get old, I don't know if it's because of the me being diabetic, or I'm gonna reach Alzheimer. But I hope I've not reached Alzheimer. I'm not scared of dying, but I'm scared of not having my memory. I think that's the worst. Okay, so this is the cash receipt of Starbucks, of the mug. So the mug was 10 euros, like I showed you, and the big mug was 13 euros. So I spent a lot of money. I spent a lot of money on the day out of Gouda, but I also did not buy a lot of things. I didn't. Some of the sets in play today, I did not buy. And I did not buy a second or a third pack of the stroopwafels, so I regret that. Some of these things I've seen in the Goudse Waag, I mean the Cheese Museum. I saw some things that I thought of, I don't... It's so expensive, I thought to myself. I don't want to buy it. But now I'm at home, I'm like, shoot, I should have bought it. So, the question is, would I visit Gouda again? Yes, I would. I totally would. Not because of the Lego Play Today store. No, I enjoyed Gouda. I enjoyed, to be honest, Delft also, but Delft was the last time I went with my boyfriend in 2014. So, that was a long time. And I enjoyed going to Delft. A lot of museums, a lot of sightseeing. And we also grabbed a terrasje, so where we can eat and drink. Oh, that was so nice. But this time, for the first time in Gouda, I went by myself. So that's a new experience. Visit cities by myself. Well, actually, I did visit the city by myself in the beginning. Only last time I was with a man in 2014 in Delft. So, yeah. I would go back to Gouda, and I want to see Delft another time. I've gone to Amsterdam plenty of times. I mean, to see the museums like Rijksmuseum, Van Gogh Museum, and other museums there. But I know there are more museums that I want to see. And there are a lot of places in the Netherlands that have museums, or a lot of towns or cities that I would also visit. But I don't want to go too far. And Gouda is just, for me, it's just, you know, 30 minutes away. It's not too far from Rotterdam. So I like that space. Because I get too tired in the train. You know, if you sit too long, and especially after a full nooked on, I felt I was in a microwave. It was so hot in Gouda. So hot. I was sweating. Oh. And I carried a big bag of Lego and a smaller bag of Lego at Intertoys. It was ridiculous. I think Jochem would have thought, wow, this little woman buys so many Lego. Well, at least I don't have that money to buy the Millennium one, the Star Wars one, the bigger one. I think it's like 800 or 900 euros. I don't have that money to buy that big one. So. Oh, I don't want to total up all the money that I've spent. It is I don't want to see that amount. I know it's a lot. I know it's a lot. If you don't count the Lego, it's already a lot. So I enjoyed so much. I didn't tell my boys that I went, because both of my boys had to work. So my oldest one worked at a Chinese supermarket, a local one here nearby, and the youngest son worked at a catering service, I mean a wok restaurant. So, but he works very late. Their shift is different. My oldest one has the day shift and my youngest one has the night shift. So, yeah. I think I'm done. I don't want to talk about the bad things happened in the Netherlands. Those are there are a lot of them, and I don't want to mention that. So I only want to say how fun it was going by train, having a day out. The city was not that big. Like I said, if you see like the top of the salad, if you walk like this and you go round, and that was it. Oh gosh. And in the center was the town hall, I mean. So if you go walk around, that was it. I didn't see the rest of Gouda. But I think there was more than that. Because it was the center of Gouda. It was not everything of Gouda. So if I want to see everything, I should have walked more. But I said to myself, you know, the center of Gouda is good enough, and it's a hot day. You know, you have to eat well and drink well. Even when it's hot, I don't like to eat and drink. Even though I'm diabetic, I'm supposed to eat like 4 or 5 times a day. Well, small portions, of course. I'm not allowed to eat big portions. So every other 3 hours I need to eat. But I wasn't hungry, and I said to myself, I don't want to pass out in the train because I didn't eat and drink. So I said to myself, let's eat and drink. And I found a terrasje at Café Central, and there were 2 good-looking waiters, and those were men. There were also 2 good-looking women, but I don't fancy women. So it was sitting there, you know, and see the waiters strutting by, you know. And it was like eye candy for me. Says the woman who has no boyfriend and no husband. So I don't care. My eyes can watch whatever they want. My eyes can feast on whatever they want. I don't hurt anyone. So there you go. Yeah, my desk is so messy. Look, everything I've bought. Cash receipts. Souvenirs. Okay, this is not souvenir. This is a brick separator. But everything on the table. I need to take pictures for Instagram. Oh my goodness. Well, I hope you enjoyed my story. The weird thing, my first story, part one, is like over 1 hour and 20 minutes. And this part, is part two, is just 16 minutes and something. So I'm sorry for that. My cell phone didn't allow me to take part one and part two at the same time in one vlog. So I'm sorry for that. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. So I want to say, I love Gouda. It was a beautiful small city and I enjoyed it very much. I enjoyed every bit, and food and drinks are excellent. I would commend anyone to go to Gouda. I enjoyed it very much. So, oh yeah, the shops. Oh, a lot of shops I saw there, we don't have it here in Rotterdam. So, yes. Retail is excellent. So I want to say, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everyone. Be safe. Be kind. Be positive. Bye.